to creation, who calls us to listen and follow, who sends us to shine like stars. Let us come before God, confessing our sin. Holy and merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against our sisters and brothers and against you. We cherish the values of this world. We cause others to stumble. The earth is wounded by our excess. Have mercy, O God. Forgive us, renew us, and raise us up on eagle's wings, that we may do your will with courage and delight. Amen. Hear the voice from heaven. You are my own, my beloved. God gives power to the weary and strengthens the powerless. Be cleansed, be healed. For in the name of Jesus Christ, I declare to you the forgiveness of your sins and the revealing of God's reign. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share God's peace by greeting those around you. It's flu season. So if you want to take precautions and have a fist bump or an elbow bump, that's fine. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
For the unity of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Holy God, creator of light and giver of goodness, your voice moves over the waters. Immerse us in your grace and transform us by your Spirit, that we may follow after your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord breaks the cedar trees. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon.
The Lord makes the ones like a cat, and the ones like a dog.
The voice of the Lord bursts forth in lightning flashes.
The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees.
the Lord makes the oak trees writhe and strips the forest bare. And in the temple of the Lord all are crying glory.
The second reading is from the book of Acts. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the interior regions and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They replied, "No, we've not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." Then he said to them, "Into what then were you baptized?" They answered, "Into John's baptism." Paul said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 of them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, for to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life.
Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the first chapter. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. I'd like to invite the children to come up. Good morning. Boy, Carter, I'm going to ask you to come a little bit closer. We're going to do something special today. When Jesus was baptized, the heavens opened up, and a voice from heaven said, who do you think was the voice from heaven? Almighty God. And he said to Jesus, "You are my Son, my Beloved. With you, I am well pleased." Some translations say, "With you, I take delight." Now, isn't that something to have God say that to Jesus? Now, guess what? When you are baptized, you may not remember this. When you were baptized, those same heavens opened up, And there was a voice from heaven that said, "You are my beloved child. With you, I am well pleased." Can you imagine God said that to you? You have to imagine it because nobody heard those words. But I imagined it. Okay? That's a blessing. God saying those wonderful words. "You are my beloved child. With you I am well pleased." So we're going to bless each other, okay? First, we're going to bless one another's ears. Did you know that when you were baptized, if I baptized you, I took my hand and put the sign of the cross on your forehead. I said, "You are sealed with the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever." And now we're going to bless each other, okay? So I want you to find a partner. You're perfect. You can find a partner. First thing we're going to bless is one another's ears. Okay? You don't sound too excited about this. Why are you looking at me that way? Here's what I want you to do. So that each of you will be able to hear the good news with your ears, I want you to go to the person next to you and do this. Receive the sign of the cross on your ears. Go ahead. Emerson, you have a partner right there. You know what? I'm going to do it. Receive the sign of the cross on your ears. Now remember, we want you to be able to hear the gospel. Receive the sign of the cross on your ears, Emerson. Receive the sign of the cross on your ears. Receive the sign of the cross on your ears. How about that? Now, that you may see the light of Christ illuminating your life. Oh, when I did do it to you, Guinevere. Now receive the sign of the cross on your eyes. You might have to close your eyes. Receive the sign of the cross on your eyes so that you can see the light of Christ. All right? Receive the sign of the cross on your eyes. Very good, Zeke. So you may see the light of Christ. Now, how about this? Receive the sign of the cross on your mouth so that you can sing praise to God, okay? Sign of the cross on your mouth so you can sing the praise to God. I'm being nice to you. I'm not even touching your mouth. Now, how about this one? Receive the sign of the cross on your shoulders. Because Jesus said, "Take my yoke upon you, for my burden is easy and my yoke is light." Okay? Sign of the cross on your shoulders. And we'll end there. We could go all the way down to your feet, but we're going to end with the sign of the cross on your shoulders. Let us pray. Repeat after me. Gracious Heavenly Father, I do pray that you bless these children. All the parts of their bodies, so they can know your love and share that love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, I enjoyed that. I may be the only one. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We're going to talk about Jesus' baptism, our baptism, affirmation, more important than affirmation, acceptance, and I said blessing and cursing. And I don't mean, when I say cursing, saying barnyard language. Let me give you an example of a blessing. I saw Kenny Rogers, one of our children, dropped a Cheerio. I saw a commercial this week with Kenny Rogers in it. Anybody see that commercial? And I said, Dolly Parton was right. Dolly Parton, I heard her talk in an interview, and someone said something about, very negative, about people who get, have plastic surgery done. And Dolly Parton said, oh, don't say that. And then the person said something about how terrible Kenny Rogers looked because of his plastic surgery. And she said, oh, don't say that. I know Kenny, he's a friend of mine, and we'd sing together, and I said to him, Kenny, don't worry, you'll grow into your face. Now, isn't that wonderful? So I saw Kenny on this commercial, and I go, Dolly Parton was right. He appears to have grown into his face. Well, she has, Dolly Parton had a wonderful way of dealing with, there's some people, especially those in show business, but other people who feel it's important to take care of their face and have work done on their face. And normally, people are very negative about it. Dolly Parton instead found a way to add a blessing in a positive way. Let me give you an example of a curse. The movie Selma came out this week, and it's about voting rights. And I have not seen the movie. I've read a few reviews of the movie. And there's a scene in the movie where a character played by Oprah Winfrey goes in to register to vote. And she needs to take a civics test. And I don't believe they gave this civics test to everyone. It was only the people that they didn't want to allow to vote. So the first question the voting judge gave her was, recite the preamble to the Constitution. And she said, we the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union. And then he stopped her and said, how many county judges does the state of Alabama have? And she answered, 67. And then he said, name them. And of course, she couldn't name them, so he stamped denied. The character playing Martin Luther King Jr. in the film said this, as long as I am unable to exercise my constitutional right to vote, I do not have command of my own life. I cannot determine my own destiny, for it is determined for me by people who would rather see me suffer than succeed. Would rather see me suffer. Want to curse my life, not bless it. Let me give you one more example of an entire city, community that decided to bless people rather than curse them. Well, at first they were cursing them, and that is homeless people. Salt Lake City had quite a homeless problem. And what do you do with homeless people? How about you pass an ordinance that says homelessness is against the law? So if you're found on the street, you get thrown into jail. So that's what Salt Lake City did. And it was costing them a lot of money, not only policing them and throwing them into jail, but the homeless people not doing well physically and having to go to the emergency rooms. And when they tallied all the costs and the food pantries and everything else, when they tallied all the costs to the citizens of Salt Lake City, they realized it cost $20,000 a year per person to allow them to stay on the street. So what would you do in a situation like that? Well, we need more police to put them in jail, right? Or we need to build a bigger jail. Instead, Salt Lake City said, let's build a bunch of apartment buildings, and actually pretty nice apartment buildings, and house them in apartment buildings. At Faith and Current Events, we had an article that talked about that. Initially, they figured it cost $7,800 a year to house them and have social workers guide their lives. And a number of them, those that were able to work, a number of them found jobs and actually started becoming productive citizens again. They found help for them for their addictions and everything else. An entire city deciding to bless rather than curse. Well, I bring this up today because we have this wonderful story of Jesus' baptism. Very short in the Gospel of Mark. Everything's very short in the Gospel of Mark. And I quoted Brian Stoffagen in our Bible studies this week, where he says this: we make the birth of Christ a very important and special event. Don't we? We still make the birth of Christ a very special and important event. It's a big deal around here. But then he goes on to say, but only two books in the Bible give us the Christmas story, Matthew and Luke. But at least six books in the Bible talk about Jesus' baptism, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, and Romans. It appears that in scriptures, Jesus' baptism is more important than his birth. Perhaps that should be a clue for us. Perhaps we should not only give greater emphasis to Jesus' baptism, but our own baptisms. I'm thankful that Rose Holbein has implemented baptismal anniversary celebrations every quarter. Everyone who is in preschool or confirmation age or below, we include them in the quarter in which they were baptized in a baptismal celebration to celebrate their anniversary. We're starting to understand our baptisms are so important. Well, what do we, so just think, the heavens opened up, and God Almighty said to Jesus, you are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased. In you I take delight. Now that wasn't the end, the climax of things in Jesus' life. That was just the very beginning. Because from then on, he was going to begin his ministry. But first, he was driven, the Gospel of Mark says, he was driven by the devil into the wilderness. And he was tempted in the wilderness. And you can imagine during that temptation, Jesus taking great comfort in that affirmation from his Father, that acceptance. It wasn't a mere affirmation. I accept you. You belong to me. You are my son, my child, the beloved, with whom I am well pleased. They say that we are more connected with people than any people have ever been. People are texting constantly, have confirmation class, and they're texting constantly. Thankfully, not my current class. Connected. But they say we are more lonely than ever. We go on Facebook, like this, constantly liking things. So we're giving people affirmation, I suppose. But what people truly need is that sense of acceptance. How do we accept people? Well, first, we have to really understand when we were baptized, we were truly accepted, claimed by God. You are my child, God said to us. When I hold children in my arms, if we baptize adults, I can't exactly hold them. But I think about that as I walk around showing a child to the congregation, how God embraces them, holds them in his warm embrace, calls each of them his child, claims them as his own, his beloved child, in whom he takes delight. Knowing that, there should be nothing in this life that we cannot handle. Nothing. We can endure. Well, first, we experience that whole divine life. And now our eyes should be different. Anthony DeMello tells a story of a young woman who was very creative, filled with anxiety, who went to a psychiatrist to explain her anxiety. He put her on a sedative and said, come back and see me in 2 weeks. And she came back to see the doctor, and he said, how have things been going? And she says, well, it's the same with me, but everybody else seems more relaxed. Anthony DeMello's point was, we too often see people through how we feel. Today, I want you to feel that acceptance and love of God Almighty. In you, he takes delight. Knowing that you're filled with that love and acceptance, that should change the way you see other people. So we experience the divine life and power. We can endure incredible hardship because we belong to God, and we know in him our lives hold together. And as people blessed by God, we can share that love, grace, mercy, that blessing with those we meet. As people blessed by God, now we can truly step out in mission. So today, I want you to hear you are God's blessed, beloved people, his children, and he takes delight in you. Amen.
faith. I believe.
Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven
and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Called to know, love, all in need. Loving God, in the waters of baptism, you claim us as beloved sons and daughters.
Shower your joy on us as we live in your acceptance and delight and share your blessings, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Loving God, your Spirit embraces all creation, giving life, growth, and beauty.
Move us to receive all we touch as your gift, and to preserve your earth for the sake of all living things now and in the ages to come. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Help us to be your light.
We pray for those mourning and coping following the massacre at Charlie Hebdo offices in Paris, France. For those who now make a difference in their challenge for freedom of speech. Around the world, there are others who mourn following the loss of life in boats and airplanes and avalanches and floods and wars and acts of terrorism. Let them taste your goodness. Send your peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Speak healing and peace to the hearts of those who suffer in mind, body, or spirit.
We remember especially Emily Callan, Opal Donnell, Mickey Fuller, Tiffany Giles, Randy Greenwood, Maynard Hansen, Dustin Jones, Jim Lampe, Pat Morrison, Suzanne Noh, Nancy Niewald, Margaret Peterson, Vera Rosso, Wayne Sproul, Mary Thomas, Janice Trotter, Joe West, Terry Wilson, and Ed Wood. Are there any others?
Loving God, we give thanks for the saints of every generation who followed your beloved Son.
Comfort the grieving, especially the family and friends of Harold Bender. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Trust in your love and healing, O God. We commend to you all for whom we pray, knowing you will hear and answer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Merciful God, as grains of wheat, those were gathered together to become one bread, so let your church be gathered together from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. For yours is the glory through Jesus Christ, now and forever.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is our duty and delight that we should everywhere and always offer thanks and praise to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, who is your light made manifest to all the nations. And so with the church on earth and all creation and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy God, creator of all and source of life, at the birth of time, your word brought light into the world. In the fullness of time, you sent your word, born of Mary, to shine in our darkness and to make us your daughters and sons. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his birth and life among us, his death and resurrection, we await his coming again, when all things will be restored in him, even as we cry. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit.
Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit.
By your Spirit, bless us in this bread and cup, that held and nourished by you, we may live as your children, shining with the light of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power of you may be seated. Second Sunday of every month, we commune via intinction, so you will receive the bread or a wafer in your hand, hold on to it until the chalice comes by and you dip or intinct it in the chalice. All is ready. Our Lord invites us. Please come. body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Everlasting God, we bless you that you have brought us to the mountaintop and filled us with the life and light of your Son. Send us in his name from this place to bring light into dark corners, healing where lives are torn, and nourishment to every hungry heart. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
You'll notice in the messenger, it says something about Harold Bender's graveside service down at the Veterans Cemetery. How many of you remember Harold? There you go, a number of you. There's going to be a graveside service down at the cemetery. Cheryl was concerned, his daughter Cheryl, that there might be a need to have a place for people to gather afterwards, and I said, well, come back to Messiah and we'll share refreshments, offer refreshments. And that's exactly what will happen. I want you to know that's happening. The memorial service, the graveside service, is at 11 a.m. on Tuesday. Danny's going to tell us about the great concert he's going to have tonight.
I remember this one.
Hello? No, it'll, let's see if it's still on. Yeah, it's still on. Hello? That's just a matter of Matt helping. Keep your hand a little higher. Just start talking.
Okay, there we go. Hi, everybody. I work at Reed Academy. I'm the middle school choir director there, and our wonderful choir was selected to be part of Missouri Music Educators Association convention, and we were the only middle school choir in the history of Springfield to be selected for this convention, so it's a really neat thing. And actually, the recordings that we made to submit to the we made at this church here, and as a matter of fact, one of the recordings we made here, we did of a piece, and the composer, he was searching through his name on Google or YouTube, and he saw our choir performing his piece, and he said he was so blown away by it because he said he hadn't expected a middle school choir to attempt to do that piece. He said, it must be done by a high school piece or a college piece, and he said he was so moved by it and moved by the school that he decided to write us a piece. So today at Messiah Lutheran, we're going to go through our whole entire program, including the world premiere of that piece as well. So that'll be at 6:30 tonight, unless Springfield freezes. If Springfield freezes, then maybe not. But aside from that, we're going to perform here at 6:30 tonight, so we hope you can attend.
The wonderful city workers will get those roads drivable. Did you say 6:30 tonight? 6:30. We have the mentoring program goes on tonight from 4:30 to 6, so people that go to that can still attend this concert. Anything else need to be announced? Good. receive this benediction. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the grace that sustains every breath we take, the love of God that gives us courage and strength, and the abiding presence of the Holy Spirit that fills our hearts with comfort and peace, be with you and all those you care about, now and forever. Amen.
As with gladness men of old did the guiding star behold, as with joy they hailed its light,
could get a smaller, a shorter light.
Guided by God, we welcome all to worship, make disciples,
hunger for ministry,
nurture youth,
gather resources for growing ministries,
offer healing and care to all in need. Go in peace, share the good news.
Thanks be to God. Good singing with you.
You did too.